You see, there was a period where Hinduism was vilified or shown in a poor light, saying you are idolatrous. You believe in idols, you worship idols. You know, there's, in fact, some temples still say, come on, I show you the idols. Hey, don't use that word. Do you know what idols mean? Or this, idols mean worshipping objects as something special. So you take a piece of stone and say, this is idol, you know, this is a worship, it's sacred, it's got magical powers, that's called idolatry. This is a horrendous idea, very outdated idea. Giving sacred status to objects, this is called idolatry. And this is how Hinduism was vilified, you are idolatrous. Oh, I have great fun when I have got people from other religion, especially the Jews, they say, Jew, we can't come in the temple. You know, they've written in our religion, thou shall not make graven images of thy God, and you have made so many, we can't come near, so we meet you downstairs. I say, fair enough, you stay here, I'll go. What is all this? Let me just tidy up. You see, from the Sanskrit term, look, simple Sanskrit term called prati, we derive two words, pratika and pratima. Prati means going towards. Pratika means a symbol that will take me towards God. Pratima means an image that will lead me to God. So we're very clear. We say we are using imagery or symbols to lead us to God. Defined as pratima and pratika from the word Sanskrit word prati. So we know what we are talking about. We are using these particular tools to relate to the infinite God. And this tool is very finite, but so what? We are using a finite tool to relate to the infinite God. We are not apologetic about it at all. As long as we operate in the finite world, look, I'm finite, I'm not infinite, you won't see me anymore here. As long as I'm finite, I've got mental faculty which are finite, I will use finite tools to talk about the infinite. We are not apologetic. Everybody does it and we do it. We do it knowingly. But mom, still kind of can't be, you know, God there. Look, we do it in every field. And this one example I used again, you can use it. Especially with people who challenge you to use this example. You say, okay, you know maths? You say, yes, I know maths. Can you put infinity on the board? They say, yeah, easy. They'll take a chalk and do a little squiggle for you. They say, that's infinite. I say, that's not infinite. You can use this example. There's number 8 that had too much to drink last night. It's toppled over. That's certainly not infinite. That's very finite. It's only this much number 8 that's toppled over. You can't call it infinite. Oh no, Mr. Lakhani, that's infinite. That's not infinite. See what you've done. You've given me a finite symbol to relate to the idea of infinity. And you are happy with it. Without it, your maths will collapse in 2 ticks. You need it, otherwise you can't do maths. Oh yes, we can't do it. See, even in the most material sciences, maths, you are using this symbolism to relate to the infinite. Why can't we do it in the name of religion? The only difference between us and you is we are doing it knowingly, you are doing it unknowingly.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.